forward head posture, this throws off the entire system. And this is from mouth breathing during childhood. Reduced respiratory muscle strength. You see the weight of the head when it's aligned perfectly. And you see that, of course, the head, so it's putting a lot of pressure here. Our study shows that oral breathing modifies head position. The significant increase of the craniocervical angles in patients with this altered breathing pattern suggests an elevation of the head and a greater extension of the head compared with the cervical spine. This is a 2015 paper. Moderate forward head posture acts as a compensatory mechanism in order to improve respiratory muscle function. You're trying to get your tongue out of the airway. But the problem with this is you have it during childhood and it will stay with you for the rest of your life. And that's one of the issues with it. Mouth breathing children had cervical spine postural changes, decreased respiratory muscle strength compared with nose breathing. The results show that adults with mouth breathing childhood, and it's the mouth breathing during the critical growth periods of these kids, 6 to 9 years of age. However, 60% of the growth of the face is achieved by 4 years of age. 60%. So if you were looking at a child's face, 60% is achieved by the time of 4 years of age, and 90% is achieved by the time the child is 12. And the face is growing until 18. And that's how critical it is. It's a very minor opportunity to get children to breathe through their noses. So mainly in the head and lumbar column, which keeps for the whole life.